Most people have probably never heard of the medical term DVT or deep venous thrombosis.
Yet it's a condition that kills more people than breast cancer and AIDS combined. And service members are not immune. Our medical editor, Dr. Paul Little, is here and he can tell us more about it.
Ashley, you're exactly right. In fact, our own Sergeant First Class Pete Mays had a near-death brush with a DVT. Here's his story. Sergeant Pete Mays is lucky to be alive. In fact, he almost didn't get to welcome his new baby girl into the world. It all started about a year ago when he was finishing a 10K race. He was about 10 meters from the finish line when he heard two loud pops.
Like gunfire going off, and I fell down clutching my leg, and I'm thinking, I just broke my leg.
Mays had a classic stress fracture, a crack in the bone that, with repeated stress, finally gave way.
Hey, honey, you remember this?
Yeah. Nice.
The treatment? A full leg cast, which he wore for a month, then a shorter half leg cast. But hours after getting the new cast, he knew something was wrong. By the fifth day, he had a knife-like pain in his right ribs, and by midnight...
He was gasping and saying, I just can't breathe well. And I said, do we need to call 911 or do we need to go? And he was like, go. So we rushed over to Reston Hospital, and he was getting worse and worse as we were going over there.
Sergeant Mays had a pulmonary embolism, or PE. Blood clots formed in veins of his immobilized leg, then broke off and traveled to his lungs, where they blocked circulation. Remember NBC reporter David Bloom? He died from a PE after sitting in an armored vehicle for hours during Operation Iraqi Freedom. Mays says if he had known that he was at risk for a DVT, he would have recognized those early symptoms and gone to the hospital sooner. And our own Sergeant First Class Pete Mays joins us here on the set. Pete, what's the bottom line here?
Well, it's really simple, Doc. Patients need to get involved in their medical care. They need to ask questions, need to find out exactly what the risks are, and medical personnel need to cover all the things that can happen and the symptoms that go with them when someone like me, who's in good shape, gets ill or injured.
Pete, thanks so much for sharing your story with us. Good luck on your next assignment. And if you'd like to learn more about DVTs, go to health.nih.gov and do a search for DVT.